Jimmy, your years as a captain of a ship down in the Caribbean is going to serve you well for this myth, ping pong ball salvage.
Yeah, it actually seems pretty familiar to me because in those days I formed a salvage company and we actually raised a sunken sailboat using garbage bags just by filling one bag up at a time. This is actually pretty similar, except we're going to be using thousands and thousands of ping pong balls to do it.
These, to raise a ship?
Yeah.
Off the bottom of the ocean.
That's the myth.
Salvage companies use large flotation bags, which are usually filled with air while on the ocean floor. A slightly different technique was used to raise a piece of Titanic's hull in 1998. The big piece weighed in at 20 tons and took five giant bags to lift, each filled with 6,000 gallons of lightweight propane. But in the 1940s, Donald Duck and his nephews had the comical idea of using ping pong balls for underwater salvage. Now, the duck has made its way into the Mythbusters Hall of Fame.
You know, one of the first questions that comes to my mind, Jimmy, is how much buoyancy does a ping pong ball have? And actually, how much space a whole bunch of ping pong balls occupies?
Huh.
What he's trying to say is they need to know some numbers before they can even consider this wacky myth. Like precisely how many ping pong balls will lift how much weight in water.
I'm going to zero out my digital scale. Then I'm going to fill this top cup with exactly 1 pound of buckshot and then see how many ping pong balls it takes to negate that 1 pound of buckshot.
If it takes too many balls, this myth may have to remain in the realm of fantasy. Jamie's skeptical about Adam's rig.
Are we going to get like a 30-foot long tong for the real thing?
It takes a fair amount of force to push it down there. The math says 15 balls.
So what's the problem? You don't believe the math?
Well, we never believe the math on Mythbusters.
That's great, Adam. I'll see you later. Let me know when you get that all worked out.
Luckily, Adam is less fragile than his rig. He resets the experiment and tries again. When the cup containing the ping pong balls floats upwards, he has his answer.
That actually confirms my math. I think that was exactly 15 balls to eliminate a pound of weight.
Here comes that sinking feeling.
That's a lot of balls for a lot of pounds.
Experiment number two is designed to find out just how many ping pong balls will fit into a confined space. Adam adopts a questionable scientific method. Please, whatever you do, don't try this at home.
Two, four.
Returning to his senses, he uses the fish tank to find out how efficiently ping pong balls pack together.
So I've got just about 300 balls in here. My space is...
Adam crunches the numbers, and they don't look pretty.
51%. 51% packing efficiency. That's crappy. What that means is that there's all this space between the balls where they can't go right up next to each other because of the fact that spheres are not very good at, like, stacking up against each other.
So far, so bad. Is this myth sunk before it's even begun?